There had been a lot of studies of aging, and the results were very confusing. When people think about changes in the gene expression, they usually think about something occurred and some gene just changed enormously. Like, you know, it's like turning the switch on the light. But when you are aging, the changes tend to be very subtle.
This is one of those projects that has aged well. We actually did a really sort of massive project in two independent cohorts of aging mice.
We had all the data. We had to think, what is the right way to look at this? What is the pattern in here? Why are our experiments' results not matching other experiments published? And when Thomas said, I found a pattern, my excitement was, there is a pattern. It was like, hallelujah, because before there was nothing.
Basically, we found it in us humans or in mice, basically animals, genes that tend to be short accelerate the aging process. And genes that are long, these were genes that would actually slow down the aging process.
We usually think about cells being in homeostasis, right? And one way to think about homeostasis is you could imagine that you have a very long tray. And now imagine then from left to right, you organize your genes and you put the little ones here and the middle ones here and the big ones here. And now just imagine that you are carrying that big tray on your head, right? If it's all balanced, it's fine. Now imagine that you actually shift things off balance. So instead of the tray having the right amount in each position, in some positions there is too much and in other ones there is too little. Now the tray is not balanced and you are trying to walk with it, it's much harder. So that's essentially what happens in aging. It's not about one gene or two genes or three genes, it's about this entire collection. I mean, there are 20,000 protein coding genes in a human cell, and the imbalance is across these 20,000.
We're putting forward a really a novel hypothesis about the mechanism of aging. It will open up a new area of investigation in aging that currently just doesn't exist.
We are finding out all of these diseases of aging, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, dementia. The cause could be this imbalance, these very, very gigantic proteins tend to be used in our brain.
How much are things actually irreversible? Because maybe if we would find a way to slow down that phenomenon that we have observed, maybe things are not that irreversible anymore.